Hi, I'm Lindell Ormsbee, representing the Environmental and Water Resources Institute Water Distribution Analysis History Project. The purpose of this project is to document the history of water distribution systems analysis. An important part of this project is a series of interviews with engineers, modelers, researchers, and practitioners who have made significant contributions in the field of water distribution systems analysis. And this interview is being conducted on May 17, 2015 in Austin, Texas. And our interview today is with Dr. Rajesh Gupta. Rajesh is a professor at the Viswasvararayan National Institute of Technology in Hagpur, India, and he's been very active in the area of water distribution systems analysis for the last 25 years. He was also a PhD student of the late Dr. Pragmat Bahavi. And so in our interview, to kind of get started, we're gonna like to ask Rajesh, how did you first actually get to know Dr. Bahavi?
Yeah, first of all, I would like to thank you for giving me an opportunity to talk about Dr. Bahavi and my association with him. I was doing my M.Tech in environmental engineering, and he taught me a subject, environmental systems optimization.
Okay.
And the way he taught that subject, and his command over that subject, and I liked that subject very much. So later on, then I opted him for my dissertation, M.Tech dissertation, and then for my PhD also. So this is that how I came in contact with Dr. Bahavi.
Okay.
Yes.
Well, I noticed that he had a very long, distinguished career. Actually, started back in 1956.
Yes.
And did a lot of work. Do you know much about his earlier research at all that you could share with us?
I know partially, but not completely. In earlier days, that he was working in the area of rainfall runoff modeling.
Right.
And then he was also interested in working in isotopes used in hydraulic engineering.
Okay.
And one of his paper in Journal of Institution of Engineers that bagged gold medal from Journal of Institution Engineers India.
Okay.
So in fact it was later in 1970s that he started working in the area of optimization, and then he completed his PhD in 1978.
Right.
So I don't know much about his earlier research work,
yes. So do you know why he got interested in water distribution analysis? Like you mentioned, I know he had his dissertation in 78.
Yes.
On that area. Do you know?
Once he said that he got the book written by Wagner on optimization, then he just gone through that entire book.
Okay.
And then he thought its application on the distribution network.
Okay.
And that is how he started his working. And that he worked on his own for even his PhD.
What was the book again that he read that got him interested?
It was on optimization by Wagner.
Wagner,
yes.
Okay. It appears that he seemed to focus much of his research on the optimal design part of that whole issue.
Yes.
And I guess he actually published his own book on that topic in 2003,
yes.
I believe.
Yes.
Were you involved in any of that book, or I guess you've done some research with him before?
Yes.
Then, right?
Yes. In fact, his first book was in 1991 on analysis of water distribution network, which was published by Technomic Publishing USA.
Okay.
And later on, then he wrote a book on optimization of distribution network, and all the problems of that book were solved by me.
Really?
Yes. Yes. All the problems. I prepared computer program and then carry out the analysis, and that is what he mentioned in the acknowledgement also.
Okay, so you solved all the problems in
yes.
Okay, that's interesting.
Yeah, and then I was associated with him in modifying this earlier book on analysis, in which that I did 5 chapters.
Okay.
And that was published from UK.
Okay.
So Alpha Science publication. And then finally he wrote also one book on water resource systems.
Okay.
So that was the third book.
All right, so I've looked at those books. They're fantastic books.
Yes.
That's quite a contribution that he was able to make with all those textbooks. I mean, are there Are there other researchers that you know that, in addition to yourself, that that he was able to mentor and kind of help lead their research as well?
Dr. V.V. Sunak was his first PhD student.
Okay.
And I was the second. So I was just doing the parallel with Professor Sunak. And later, Dr. Kadu and Dr. Agarwal. So we did PhD under him. But only Dr. Kadu was in the research area or maybe academic area.
Okay.
Otherwise, they were, and then he's still continuing. And this year that he has got the Visiting International Fellowship Award for attending this conference.
Okay.
So he's also here.
Oh, that's in this, fantastic.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I look forward to speaking
yes.
with him. Well, how would you summarize the impact of Dr. Bahavi on your own career? Back in, on that.
In fact, that today whatever I am is because of him, and because he taught me that how to consider or to look into the problem from the basic.
Okay.
And then he always used to tell me that we should use the mathematics as a tool. We should not go just behind the mathematics. We should try to use some logical approach and coupled with mathematics to solve the problem.
Okay.
And I was associated with him as a student, then as a colleague in the department, and later on then some of the students we guided together for PhD. I was also involved with him for writing a book and for some consultancy work assignment also.
Okay.
So he told me that means entire thing that how to do it, and he was working only in one area, that is a distribution network.
Right.
Then
kind of
yes.
Focus area.
Focus area.
Yes. All right.
Yes.
So I guess you really started working with him in the 1990s, early 90s. Is
yes.
That
yes. Early 90s. Yes. So in 89 I did my M.Tech with him. Then in 91 I registered for my PhD.
Okay.
With him. And then I worked with him up to 2011 till.
Sure.
Yes.
Sure.
Yes.
So what was your dissertation on, Dr. Gupta?
My dissertation was on reliability-based analysis and design of water distribution network.
Okay.
Wherein that I developed some parameters by which we can assess the reliability, and then we can design. And another methodology was given for the design of distribution network. To obtain a particular level of reliability.
Okay, now that's still a very, I think, important area of research.
Yes.
I know, you know, I've done a little bit of work in that in
yes.
the past. I know other people are looking at that. With the security yes. issues that,
yes.
that we're all looking at, that's still a very hot topic. So what are you looking at now with regard to that specific problem, or how are you looking to kind of tackle that? Are there some general things that you're doing?
Yeah, later on that I extended that work also, considering the nodal storage facility. Like in India, that we store the water, that we don't have the 24-hour supply.
Right.
So in such a case, that how to get the entire supply available in the 24 hours.
Right.
So that one of my PhD students, Agarwal, that he worked on that topic. And then I also worked on water quality reliability analysis and water quality reliability based design of distribution network. Then one of my paper is on upgrading of distribution network for the level 1 redundancy. And still this is a challenging area where lot of work can be done.
Okay.
Yes.
Have you focused on some other areas as well as the reliability issue? After your dissertation, did you look at some other topics related?
Yeah, I worked on optimal design of water distribution network using genetic algorithm.
Okay.
Wherein that we have suggested how to reduce the search space. And I worked in the area of fuzzy analysis and design of distribution network with fuzzy parameters, the uncertain parameters.
Okay.
Then I worked also in the area of the sensor placements in water distribution network,
okay.
water quality sensors, and also that analysis of distribution network considering consumption along links. Normally the usual assumption is that demands are concentrated node,
right.
but it is distributed along the links. So we have developed a head loss formula for that, and then use different methodology to solve a problem of analysis.
Okay. So trying to take in consideration more some of the spatial impacts of demands across the network with regard to how they may affect the withdrawals and pressures and so on.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Where do you see research going in our field, say, the next 20 years or so? If you had a new student that wanted to start on, say, a dissertation,
yes.
What might you suggest, what areas they may want to think about looking at?
One of the thing is that a lot of automation is going on, and now we have the field results easily available because we are using some data loggers to get the pressure and flow readings continuously. And that tells more about the network. So we can have a better calibration of the system with type of data. And there were several assumptions which were made earlier. Like even the head loss equation, people were using the head loss Hegeman's formula. And we know that even that is not very correct, and it should be Darcy's formula should be used. So this is now shifting, and people are more now using towards that one. Even as I told you, the consumptions are even the demand pattern, that how is the demand pattern, and how is the behavior of the network. So that is now the another area where people are working, and then we'll be able to understand the network behavior in a better way.
Okay.
Yes.
And so kind of similar to that question, what areas are you personally looking at right now and working in, and kind of anticipate you'll continue?
Yes, now even the recent research has shown that even water demand is pressure dependent. It is not at every node that we consider only one head to presume that the demand is satisfied.
Okay.
Like your even the fire, your losses, so they are pressure dependent. So if you want to design a network with such pressure dependent demands,
right.
Then how to use some optimization methodology, and
okay.
So that is one of the area in which I am working.
Okay.
Then sensor placement is another area where I am presently working.
Okay.
Yes.
Any other thoughts about Dr. Bahavi or your own research that you'd like to share as we kind of close the interview?
Yeah. One thing that I would like to tell about Dr. Bahavi, that he was a thorough gentleman and down-to-earth person, and equally that he was a very tough taskmaster. So it was very difficult to work with him because his expectations were very, very high, standards
okay.
were very high. And lot of work that he did earlier was with only the calculator. So he has so much of patience. He used to wake up early in the morning at 3 o'clock, and he used to tell me also that I should also do the same thing. So he says that 3 to 5, that you can have a better concentration. And one thing which I remember, that when I started working with him, one paper was published, and he told me that we will send a discussion on that one. And what you do, that you have the linear programming model with you, find out the solution using your model.
Right.
Then I used this my model, and then I found that the results are not matching. I told him that this is now that results are not matching, there is some discrepancy is there. Then he said, you better check it again. Then I checked twice, thrice. Then I wrote on a register, and then showed him that this is now like this. This is what is, something is wrong here.
Right.
Then he said, okay, then you come on a holiday. Then he sat with me for 3 hours with calculator and checked each and every calculation. And then he got satisfied that whatever I'm saying is correct.
Okay.
So this means so much passionate about his research. And there is another story, that when Dr. Kadu was working for his PhD and his dissertation, his thesis was on submission, and at the time that he got operated for his eye, so one of the eye. Then Dr. Kudu said that he will submit it later, now you take a rest. He said, no, that I can see from my second eye. And then with by closing on one eye, and then he checked his entire thesis with that one. So
it was,
yes, it's very amazing.
Yeah, I think you all actually did a discussion on one of my papers years ago.
Yes, well. Yes, yes.
I think you did. That was yes. Very good. That's a very good comment. So,
yes.
Anyway, well, thank you so much for agreeing to kind of interview with us, and especially some of your stories and recollections about Dr. Bahavi, and also some of the work that you're also doing, Dr. Gupta. So
yes.
We thank you so much for doing that.
Thank you very much. And again, giving me an opportunity to talk about Dr. Bahavi. It's always a pleasure for me.
Good.
Yes.
Well, thanks again.
Yeah.